They're programmed in CSH. It's not like ZSH at all. And they say it's called C shell because it's supposed to be more C-like. But that's a lie. All right. The other thing I want to try and get done in the next year is an optional tree structure. This will require us to write a bunch of policy first and get that built out. But basically, it would be using opt-epl. Opt-epl bin, opt-epl lib, it'd be like user local. Just think of it as like user local, but in opt. The reason is that epl, I can't use opt bin.
Can't put opt bin because that's a reserved space. Only like the FHS and some of the other stuff, only the site user can build this stuff in opt bin.
Fixes something. And I guess that would be the same thing with Ruby, but we have things that are already in RHEL that we don't want to overwrite or overbuild, that we want to be able to say, okay, we have an alternative for, and so it competes with what's already there, but it's not a replacement for. It's not going to overwrite, it's not going to replace Python 2.7 on EL6 or say Python 2.7 on ELA, because I can't say the other name. Would be when there's only 3.6 involved. Yes, sir?
Okay, so software question allows you to install multiple things in that software question. You can have Postgres non-justification for software. That's a lot of extra work, and there's also a lot of things you have to run and say, I want to enable this software question. Work.
This is only meant to be for packages that compete. Yeah, RHEL or, yeah. So this is,
this off tree is not there.
Does that make sense, or is it? Yes, and that's yeah. Yeah, no, I understand that. That would have to be tested and stuff like that, but we've already kind of had to test that when the work was done for the 2.6 Python and such. The last thing I wanted to get ideas on is we have a lot of stuff going on for the rest of this conference on containers and modularity. And that is stuff that will affect us in a release, whenever that release occurs. There's multiple paths for Apple to go. Apple could say, we're not doing it. We're just going to stick to what we have, because that's what we have. There is tying into whatever infrastructure modularity is doing and working with that. And then there is some variant in between the two. I'd like to get an idea from people who actually use Apple of what they want in this, because going up, wrong talk. Talk that has all the pictures in it. There's a long ramp up time for any Apple L RHEL to get picked up. When RHEL 8 comes out, it will be 2 years before there's a large user space of it. It'll be 4 years before it probably beats what the other releases are currently using at. People are much more slow in adopting things, even when it looks like it would be much better for them to do so. Even when they said they would switch all their hardware out to the new rigs or the new software, they're very slow, much slower than what people think when they're building stuff. I don't think we have to get it right the first time. We have some time to work around some of the problems and get it whatever we're going to do as 8 comes into play. But we do need to think about it and have policies involved. So, from the audience, what are people's ideas on modularity? Should... I've heard multiple people say that they, but they're also, no problem, everything okay, or, okay, you might as well leave the door open because it's starting to, yeah, or at least I am over here. I've heard multiple people come up and say that this sounds like it would solve everything, but... No, I mean, there's multiple pieces, but some of it has been, as I found out when I brought it up, parts that are no longer in play for where modularity is going to be at certain times. And so it's like, I don't know what modularity is enough yet to know what, and I don't think we all know yet, because we're baking it. We have a good idea, but as we're baking it, we don't know if the souffle is going to hold or if it's going to collapse in certain places. So I do believe it will solve certain things. The multiple trend, Carl here is talking about how modularity would solve one of the problems that IUS sees. Carl? Other place I've run into it horrible. Actually it was finance, but I'm trying to use words that aren't going to get bleeped and cause problems for the technician. Java. Most of the financial solutions I've had to deal with Java, I've had to install 4 different versions of Java on the same machine and have them all working at the same time. Well, I mean, it does, but the finance is where it comes in, because the fact is that we can kind of play around with it, maybe get 1.8 to work on all the older ones, but if you have got an Oracle license, and you've got a SAP license, that SAP license is to use that version of Java that is for this tool, and if you use anything else that, you lose all technical support on that problem. That when you have a, and when checks are involved, they will, so you'll end up with a system that has 1.4, even though 1.4 is not around anymore, 1.5, 1.6, and 1.7 all running at the same time to get a check printed, or some similar thing. And so that is kind of case, but this, that's actually an SEL problem, not, or something else. I'm not trying to solve that with Apple, because all I want to do is have one and one. The simpler case where Python 2.6 and 2.7 need to be on the same box, or 2.7 and 3.7, or whatever Python 3 is at the moment, where somebody needs to have both of those things running at the same time so that they can do something. Or the other one that's usually the case is, used to be PHP, where you have two different apps that you needed running, one of them running on one web server that needed PHP 7.6 dot something, and then something that was 5 dot something, and that type of thing. Now, I mean, in some cases you put those in different containers, and that's what you should do, or you put them on different virtual machines, but products don't think that way. They think you have, you know, you will put it the way that the $10 million license product told you to put it, and you will get the software somehow installed that way. But streams won't work for that, because I know that it won't install two different things at the same time, and I'm not wanting it to do. I'm wanting it more to do the, I want to have this, and I need to choose it. But my thing is one of the things I was talking about listening to is, can Apple produce some streams and another repository produce some streams? What happens when they conflict or when they don't conflict? Yeah, or is only one the module only be able to be produced from one repository? And that would solve a lot of most of the things. The reason I put in the op stuff is I don't expect it. It may not need to be done in 8. It's mainly meant the op solution that I was talking about earlier. It may be, there will be cases probably, but the main reason for it is people will be wanting 6 and 7 until 2020. They'll want 6 until 2022. They'll want 7. I agree, but you also know how many people want to put run containers on EL6. I'm saying the opposite, though, because they're only allowed to have EL6 in their environment. Sorry, you keep thinking. I keep thinking you're about to ask me something, and I keep talking, and then you go. So I'm like, okay, sorry. Well, one of the big things I'm wanting to talk with it here is, I don't want to do the 10-year thing in Apple anymore. It doesn't make sense for. RHEL has broken that promise. RHEL itself, the original promise back in 2007 for 5 years at that time, and then became 7, then became 10, was RHEL will not change any APIs or ABIs or update anything once the release comes out. It will, whatever you have in that RHEL is going to stay the same. We will backport fixes and additions, but we will not break anything. We will not update anything. You'll have to wait to the next major release. That flew for some customers, but not for most of them. And most customers eventually said, well, yeah, that's really nice, but we really want that later desktop. We're really sick and tired of this 10-year-old GNOME. We want you to update this. We want you to update this. We need you to put this in here so we will use your product. And so various things have been brought in newer during these minor releases. Our Apple policy is still built around something from 10 years ago. And it's time for us to move to a structure where we match what RHEL is doing. Where when a minor release comes out, we are able to, when a minor release comes out, we're branching off of something, and stuff can be updated greatly if a developer needs it to. Yeah, currently we don't have availability for anything older than what's current. It isn't pointing to an external repo to Koji. It would require us to activate. There's multiple issues involved. It would require us getting more storage. It would require us having an external repo that we would then point and stick to. But they're all solvable problems. The main issue is a lot of those problems require dedicated time and engineering when all the other things are going on. And Apple, for better or for worse, is spare time work from the from the sysadmins here. It's been that way. I'm trying to figure out ways to bring in more people who can look at what we've got and then work out how to do this so that we can. So it's a great idea if we can do it. We may not have our time and resources to be able to implement it until somebody else does some of the work to get it there. I mean, I can go and figure out how to get the EUS licenses installed and downloaded. I don't have access to the Koji stuff to have it be able to point to different repositories, different tree repositories over time. That was one of the big issues in the past, where Koji was a black box that you don't touch unless you have black candles, a black rooster, and hello, how are you, sir? Can you give a name? Can you give a name? I can announce the name. Okay. He's not here. He's being looked for. he's not here is being looked for. Yeah, go get yourself a root beer. It's like a sarsaparilla, which is it's okay. He's not here. We'll be looking for you later. Have to use CentOS for that. It's great for collaboration. Because we would have to do it out of CentOS, because anything that would leak RHEL packages would basically be the end of. No. I'm working on it. I'll be walked to the door at the end of this day, one way or the other. You actually now know more than Ralph does, and he wrote it. That's something some people ask for, whether they want, you know, they'll ask for it, whether they want it. yeah. You know, yeah. I'm just thinking about the poor amount of storage. But one of the things I wanted to say before is I want to thank SUSE for sponsoring our talk on Apple. Their open build system is rock solid, and I appreciate their money and time. And with that, I think we're pretty much, we have time here, but I don't see us, the people who were supposed to be here, it turns out they're in a talk that's I needed some release engineers to talk about what things were possible or need. Although we do have Ralph. Because most of the things that we are stuck on are needing some unknown amount of coding in the build system. And it's a matter of yes, I will. We'll say that things seem to, because you get the over the hill wall drop, and then nothing we knew. Yes, you fixed everything, but we didn't realize you fixed this and this type things. Now we'll know that you fixed this, and then you fixed this. yes, that's the main things for it are. What I'd like to be able to do is figure out how to either set it up. Is CBS Koji? I want to set it up, that, and this is not as much a Koji change. It will be a Koji change, I guess, in some ways, but it'll also be a other RHEL-eng stuff of making it so that the faster packages, the CR, CentOS release type stuff, can be built in CBS from the Fedora trees. Because, one, our Koji is overloaded. The person who walked out of here, red hair, Kevin, has been working on a Koji problem, build problem, for 2 days now because of load issues. It's all the other underground stuff that shows up every time we have a big, massive change in infrastructure. Storage is slow. Storage is limited. I/O is not as big as everyone thinks it is because everybody wants their stuff at the same time. Those are things that Koji is as 30 terabytes, sorry, 60 terabytes of everything, not counting all the new builds that are coming through modularity. And adding in CentOS trees into our stuff. One of the other things is trying to figure out how to deal with CentOS external repos and stuff like that. Getting the builds built off of CentOS versus RHEL. No, this is only for this is only for the rawhide. Okay, no problem. So this is one of the first things in here is that I would like to have a faster moving tree set. The last couple of minor releases for RHEL has broken the world for a lot of CentOS users and a lot of RHEL users, because we could either satisfy the RHEL users or we could satisfy the CentOS users during the 2 or 3 weeks or month between 7.3 and 7.4, 6.8, 6.9. Those, and while we do that, we also found all the packages that had been moved in and out, that we had duplicates of, that we had to get rid of, but we couldn't see because of certain other problems, and it'd be nicer to have a set of a rawhide for 7 and 6 where packages are being built. I called it continual release, but it could be sent through CBS, sent through the CentOS CI for testing of install all various tests, and then built would be available for CentOS users. It would have more packages than Apple does because the packages could be don't have to have a promise on them of we're going to support this. Currently, Apple packages, we promise that we will support a package for 7 years. So, the next page. So, on the Apple side, so this is in the CentOS side. CentOS side would have this continual release tree available to it, where it's built against CentOS, packages are being built continually or fast moving. If people want to have later stuff and they don't want to care about Nagios changing from 4.3 to 5 because upstream has moved up to 5, they can be on that tree. When 7.5 comes out, RHEL 7.5 comes out, we would branch off of whatever things are in the CR tree at that time, just like a rawhide would. So, Apple would branch off of 7.5, and there would be a 7.5, Apple 7.5 tree. That tree would be built of the packages that people want to be in Apple, so it's only things like, I want to maintain Nagios, and I'm going to maintain Nagios, as in I'm going to backport stuff or do whatever needs to be done for that 7.5 to 7.6 release time. Or I have a long-term support release, you know, like MediaWiki 1.23 is going to be supported till blah, blah, blah year, so I don't mind putting it in there. And they patch it, so I'll just drop the patches in and updates. It's branched off. Instead of currently Apple, every time, every day when releases are done, we make Apple into its own repository tree, just like it was a release. There's no updates or any of the other subtrees that we have in Fedora. It's just, it's like building a whole new release. And if certain things break, the Apple release doesn't get built. That takes a lot of resource time on certain things. What I'd like to be able to do is we do that once per release, and then updates go into an updates testing, and that updates testing then gets pushed into an updates tree. So there's now, just like you'd have with a Fedora release, there'd be an Apple. There's an Apple updates and an Apple updates testing. And the smaller tree is easier to compose and can be composed without, and we can track certain things. And then when 7.5, 7.6 comes out, what we would do is we would build, we would branch again to 7.5, treat it like a new release. 7.4 would be moved to archives. And people who need to have 7.4 for however long they want it can go back to and just keep pointing to the archive server and get their old stuff. Won't be updated anymore, it'll be dead. Most of them don't care. They're looking for something that's, you know, their servers are usually rock solid. They don't want changes if they're on the EUS installs. And so they currently, the other big problem it solves is because we compose every day, if I have a problem with my package, something, you know, when we did the changeover to Pager in source, a lot of packages got pulled out of Apple. Nobody wanted those packages out. It was just a side effect bug, but for a couple of days, 30 or 40 people packages and their dependencies were all gone out of Apple. Pardon? Yeah. So this is to stop that from happening. Because 7.4 will be there. 7.4 will be there. Whatever's in 7.4 stays there. It doesn't, there's not a new compose that will all of a sudden pull those out. Yeah. And that's, yeah. It's to use the same technology and the same methods that we use in Fedora on that versus having a separate set of technology. That's where I think Koji and Bodhi and some of the other stuff might have problems with it. I don't know how much work that would take because we're now dealing with multiple moving parts. It might be just easier to just do in the past. Now, again, we had in slower installs, it looked like the better way of doing it was to have CentOS do its own thing. I'm not trying to exclude CentOS, because CentOS people could still use Apple. There's a certain set of people there's a certain set of CentOS users who want fast-moving stuff in RHEL of certain things. They're wanting continually releases. The PHP users, possibly. When I'm dealing with my Node.js package, most of the people want the latest Node.js. They're very angry that we were at 2.15 years after 2.15 was end of life. But that's what RHEL had been using. in certain things. I moved it to 4.3 so I could get all the security bugs and close out all these CVEs and such. And out of 80 tickets, I have three people who are really, really angry because certain checks no longer work they did back to there. They want me to go back to 250. But that's the thing. Most of the people want this sort of shorter life stuff. And I'm wanting to make it so that we can do that. One of the big issues is that we couldn't do x86-32 and ARM32 and ARCOGY because the CentOS cycles and the RHEL cycles diverge, so building against CentOS while RHEL has different things breaks certain code geology. Maybe in 8 we can do that. In 7 and 6, which is our... No, it's not. It's going to have to be the next one. They'll have to... The side conversation, but it's not new enough because there's certain things that just came in to DNF that need to be. No, it doesn't live on the same net app. It runs on a separate system, but there are security and policy reasons why they are separate. And those policy things are set by SEC rules and certain other things. Don't ask me. I got in a long conversation with a lawyer one time. My eyes glazed over, and I just said, okay, yes. Those things have not passed. The packages that are in there are not covered under the export control licenses. They are internal build units. Packages that are gotten from Access are covered by certain agreements that we have with many different countries on export controls. Yes, so we have to pull it out of that mirror and then put it back in to a place. That's just, again, don't ask for a technical solution for a legal problem. It's Yeah, that would be, but I don't think we're, that's a large amount of writing to write a whole different thing to start making different red. That would be making Coper. To make it separate. You know, if I'm understanding what you're asking, which is,
I'm not really for against, I'm just wondering, is that how it would be?
I was treating it just like another EPL. It would just be another repository that you would aim at, and the NVR, the highest NVR wins. And again, this is a proposal. It's not set in stone. I'm defending it because it's a proposal, but at the end of the day, after everyone has brought up everything, there are probably good ideas that I'm kind of going, well, you can't do that, and I'll go at the end of the day going, oh, well, that was actually a very smart thing. The whole opt-EPL is actually a reply to a certain one-eyed person who was against EPL for a long time, who wanted this one side thing, and it fixes that one problem. But I'm not trying to over-engineer it to make it solve every problem.
Modularity seems like it could be a more holistic solution to the whole thing, but like you said, we're probably not ever going to get that in 6, and we don't know to what extent we get modularity in 7.
Yeah, I mean, maybe 7, I don't know. The reason I said he says that is 5.10 was supposed to be the last 5, but 5.11 did have some rebase, just a couple of things, but it was just enough to find what the were you thinking. So broke the world. And then we'll probably have to have the same thing happen when the next major security, I mean, that big change was because there was just no way you could fix some of the SSL security problems. And there's been word that there are other ones coming in, so it's like, eventually. Is that the equivalent of a module token to side? To side tab? I understand. The reason is I just want to set it. I don't know who you work for or. Hi, Dan Callahan. I will tell you later after this, when the mic's off, why the conversation I had and why. But I just wanted to set your expectations of if he needed to have it, if you were thinking it was going to be done next week, if you weren't working for Red Hat and you didn't know all this crap was going on. It could wait till after 27, because I think by that point there's so many shitstorms going on right now.
Beep.
that I don't want to add more to them, and we've got people freaking out over minor things, so. Trying to make